Welcome back to our little show here on the internet. Glad you found us. Got a good topic today. We're going to talk about straight out of camera, S-O-O-C. What is it? What's it mean? What's the big deal? Really, it's our topic today, how to get better straight out of the camera JPEG results, regardless of which camera you use. These are all techniques that are going to be in front of the lens. That's what we're doing today. Thanks for coming. We'll be right back. Doing the best you can, well, it's all right. As long as you lend a hand. You can sit around and wait for the phone to ring. Waiting for someone to tell you everything. Sit around and wonder what tomorrow will bring. Kind of a cool little junkyard. We are working on a new recipe that I've got locked and loaded. Provia Punch. It's using the Provia simulation. It's kind of Fuji's traditional, it's their basic one. Recipe is from Mark G. Adams from One Camera, One Lens. And it's a good one. It's the basic Provia with just a little bit of hit of some color, and it looks like a little bit of contrast. So it's a really basic profile, but a fun one nonetheless. And that's kind of how it works with these film recipes. You kind of have to shoot them a little bit and see what works. That's what we're up to. So you might ask, Dan, what makes you so cool that you can't take your photos into a computer in a raw format and do it like the rest of us? I could, I can, I'm able. I just like to do it this way, that's all.
I really enjoy the challenges of shooting JPEGs because it's kind of like a really nice natural
way of photography for me. So that's what this episode's gonna go for. Just about every type of photography, you wanna look for interesting light sources. You wanna look for interesting colors. You wanna look for interesting light. Well, it's all right, even if they say you're wrong. Well, it's all right, sometimes you gotta be strong. Well, it's all right, as long as you got somewhere to lay. Well, it's all right, every day is judgment day. Maybe somewhere down the road away. Not much to be had interesting out here today. Got kind of an interesting sky. Go wide on that. See what we can do. Anyways, yeah, you'll want to look for good sources of light because without the digital workflow part, without the editing, you're not gonna be able to go too far with those files, bringing them out of highlight clipping and shadow clipping. And speaking of which, when you're shooting straight out of camera, you gotta be willing to shoot over the highlight and get clipping. You gotta be willing to shoot into shadows and get the blue blinkies. You gotta be willing to do that because that's part of your palette. I don't do it intentionally ever, but I have to be accepting of it because I don't have the ability to go into Lightroom or whatever your editor of choice is and fix it. Maybe somewhere down the road when somebody plays the purple haze. Well, it's all right, even when push comes to shove. Well, it's all right, if you got someone to love. Well, it's all right, everything will work out fine. Well, it's all right, we're going to the end of the line. Don't have to be ashamed of the car I drive. I'm just glad to be here, happy to feel that. The end of the line, of the line. And it don't
don't matter if you're by my side.
To shoot straight out of camera, JPEGs, you gotta be willing to make some compromises. And some of those compromises are gonna lay in the highlights and shadows. When you're doing JPEGs, sometimes you just gotta go with it. Another that goes along with that is film grain is your friend. Goes a long ways towards adding sharpness, the fall off, and it has its own beauty. So film grain is one of the things that you bring on intentionally. I even jack up my ISO sometimes just to get digital feedback and to get digital noise, you know, torture the sensor and see what it can do. It's a fun way to do it. Grain, noise, dirty sensors, dirty lenses, dirty filter. I don't get them dirty on purpose. They just get dirty. What I do is when they get dirty, I'll use them right before I clean them. Little bit of grit. Every little bit counts when you're shooting JPEGs. Exposure has a lot to do with pulling it off. Underexposing the film recipes seems to get a little more out of them. You know, if you're shooting Kodachrome 64, if you underexpose that by a stop or 3/4 of a stop, works out glorious. Be willing to use advanced filters once in a while. Toy camera's not a bad thing. Miniature camera's not a bad thing either. Learn about recipes. You go online and read about the film itself, the actual film, and the properties that the film had, and that gives you some inclination on how to shoot it. It's really a fun way to do it. When you're shooting into light, each one of those recipes shows you exactly on the feedback, shows you exactly what that recipe looks like when you shoot light through it. It's not a bad way to go, especially when you're straight out of camera. Then you can fine-tune your exposure a little up, a little down, and roll with it that way. Lens flare. Shoot into the sun. Go ahead, knock yourself out. You're shooting JPEGs. Have fun with it. So use filters. I use a couple different filters on a regular basis. The Moment CineBloom filter. Really like how that filter works, especially on a bright day, especially when you're using light. Really a neat filter. The other I've really grown attached to is the Pro Mist filter. A little bit of lightening up on the focus really gives things a nice look. You've got things like Captain Look, who uses an FLD filter. You know, these get some really intricate looks and really a fun way to shoot. You gotta try and get things the look you want before it gets to that sensor. I would say of all my different ways of shooting or ways of doing exposure, the one that recently has made the most difference in my photography is spot point metering. I really like it. Put your exposure into a very small square. Some really interesting exposure scenarios that I wouldn't choose off the top of my head. Nothing too spectacular, but we've got some good contrast with some blue coming through there. Anyways, that's my quick list. Some of the processes I use. Let's hear from some other JPEG shooters. How do you, what other tricks do you do? Thanks so much for joining me. We're gonna shoot our way home, JPEG style. Hopefully that gives you a little more indication of what the straight out of camera thing is all about. It's a way to find solutions for photography within the camera. That's all it is. I don't spend any time editing anything but video anymore. I'd have no more reason to shoot a raw photo than a raw photo would have to shoot a JPEG photo. You know what I'm saying? This works the other way. Hey, thanks so much for coming.